So, hello, dear students. Today we'll start our what are the different objective of mixed design as well as what are the different factors which are going to influence your mixed design of concrete, and as well as we will see today lecture what are the different methods which are available to design your concrete mix. In last lecture already we have done with one numerical how to design a concrete mix by using IS 1069/2009. So in this lecture we will see what are the different objective of this mixed design. To achieve the design or desired workability in a plastic stage. What is mean by plastic stage? When your concrete will become hardened, that stage will become a plastic stage. To achieve the desired or minimum strain at a hardened stage, that is nothing but your second objective of mixed design. To achieve the desired durability as well, depending upon the environmental condition, that should be your concrete should be durable in all type of environment. So that is the next design mix objective. To produce a concrete as well as economical for oil point of view. Which point of view? It is nothing but your cost, material and equipment. So your concrete should be economical from oil point of view. So these are the basic objective of your concrete mix design. Now, what factor you should consider while designing a concrete mix? First is a cost. Second is a specification of your material, workability, strength and durability. Now we'll see one by one. First of all, the cost. The cost of concrete is made up of material cost, equipment cost and labor cost. The variation in the cost of material arises from the fact that the cement is several times costlier than the aggregate. As we all know, the basic the cost of cement is more than a aggregate, which is a fine aggregate or coarse aggregate. You can take any aggregate. So it is a natural in a mixed design to aim is to lean concrete as a possible. What is mean by lean concrete? So that you can reduce your cement content by using some admixture. That will become your economical concrete. That will give you your economical concrete. Therefore, all possible steps should be taken to reduce the cement content of concrete mixture without sacrificing the desirable property of concrete. What are the desirable concrete property? Which is nothing but your strength and durability. Strength and durability should not affect your concrete as you are lowering your cement content. So these are the basic condition you will need to take a consider. As well as one more thing I want to tell you, when you will go to the site for your construction purpose or working purpose, one will say you design your project management in the desired amount, in desired period, you can to complete your project. So they will directly, senior engineer will directly assign you one job, triple M. What is triple M? MMM. Triple M stands for material, machinery and manpower. Always remember this thing. This is the extra three M's. Three M's are more important in case of any project management for your construction point of view. As a trainee engineer, they are expecting you, you should know the triple M. Triple M is nothing but manpower, material and machinery. Without this thing, you cannot able to construct your proper in a desired time with a proper strength and durability in case of mixed design. Okay, so these are this is about the cost. As we know, material is having the higher. If you are saving, hello, are you able to hear me, students? हेलो
कॉल अगर जाएंगे लैड करा ना लेवल वेटिंग लाइक
हां सो दैट द वेरिएशन इन द कॉस्ट ऑफ मटेरियल द मटेरियल इक्विपमेंट एंड द लेबर कॉस्ट सो दीस आर द डिफरेंट स्पेसिफिकेशन नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज अ स्पेसिफिकेशन मींस व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट स्पेसिफिकेशन द कंप्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ रिक्वायर्ड शुड बी मिनिमम वाटर सीमेंट रेशियो इज आल्सो मिनिमम cement content to avoid the shrinkage is also minimum and aggregate and density of concrete is also maximum. So always remember this condition for your concrete mix design. What should be the compressive strength of required is a minimum, minimum, it should not be minimum, it should be a maximum compressive strength required in your given desired mix, as well as maximum water content and cement content, maximum aggregate and cement ratio, as well as density of concrete should be more in case of gravity dams or any construction of dam. The maximum density of concrete should be there, because if density is more, then you can say the water will not be permeable through that concrete. Hence, the density is maximum in case of any wear structure, or you can say the gravity dam structure. Now, the next thing you should consider is the workability. We all know that what is the workability is ability of flowing of concrete is nothing but workability, and how does it affect? We know that if you want a workable concrete, then water cement ratio should be more. But we also know that if water cement ratio is needs to increase, the durability of concrete is going to be decreased. So it is very important to make your proper workability concrete. You can say the workable concrete. The consistency of concrete should know more than the necessary for placing, compacting and finishing. What is mean by consistency? I hope you remember what is mean by consistency of cement and what is mean by consistency of concrete. For concrete mixes, required high consistency at the time of placing. The use of water reducing and retarder admixture should be placed rather than the adding more water. So these are the different remedies. You can say that if you are using our water cement ratio, the durability and strength will be directly affected, and we should not deal with that. So hence you will need to add some admixture. So what are the different water reducing admixture? You know that set retarding is nothing but a plasticizer and super plasticizer, which will directly reduce your water content more than 30 to 40% water you can reduce if you are using plasticizer and super plasticizer. Wherever possible, the cohesiveness and finishability of a concrete should be improved by increasing sand aggregate ratio. Always remember, the cohesiveness and finishability of concrete should be improved by increasing the sand aggregate ratio, and by increasing the proportion of fine particle in the sand. You can always remember this. This is a multiple choice question. The cohesiveness and finishability of a concrete is improved by sand aggregate ratio, water cement ratio, aggregate sand ratio, and A and C. So you can apply the sand aggregate or aggregate sand ratio. So always remember this point for your concrete mix in case of a workability of a concrete. Now next is nothing but a basic consideration in design mix is a strength and durability. Strength and durability require lower water cement ratio. As we know, we are adding your admixture to mix your design concrete. So strength and durability should be achieved by lowering the water cement ratio. It is usually achieved not by increasing the cement content only, but by lowering the water at the given cement content. We know that we are going to add your water by the weight of cement only. I hope you are remembering when we are mixing the fine aggregate, coarse aggregate and cement in dry mix, you will need to always add your water by the percentage weight of your cement. So hence this point is very important. The usual durability and strength is not only achieved by increasing the cement content, but by lowering the water content, you can achieve your desired strength and durability of concrete. Water demand can be lowered by throughout control of the aggregate grading and by using a water reducing admixture. We know that aggregate grading is having 10, 20 and 30 for nominal mix design, not nominal, you can say the design mix. It is a design mix. See, there are two types of mixes. One is a nominal mix and second one is a concrete mix design. So we will see both in this lecture also. So what water reducing admixture? What are the water reducing admixture? Plasticizer as well as super plasticizer. So these are the water reducing admixture. So in this, take a screenshot of this grade of concrete. I hope you know the different grade of concrete. If you don't know the different grade of concrete, you can take this screenshot. Always remember, M10-15-20 stand for ordinary concrete? This is also multiple choice question, so remember this grade as well as group. So M10 to M20 is nothing but ordinary concrete. M25 to M55. M25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50 and 55 is nothing but a standard concrete. This is a having a group standard concrete. And the last group is having M60, 65, M70, M75 and M80. This grade designation belongs to the group of high strength concrete. And we know that what is M? M is nothing but mixed proportion. And 10 and the rest of the number, you can say that designation of a grade is nothing but characteristic compressive strength of concrete at 28 days in Newton per mm square. That is nothing but FCK. This desired strength is achieved in a lab by using your size of QVs, 150 by 150 by 150. This is the size of cube we have casted in our lab to get a design different grade designation for your concrete mix design. 150 by 150 by 150 at 28 days. So I hope you have taken the screenshot of this because this is very important for your multiple choice of view, multiple choice question. Remember the group and grade designation. Okay, now the next part is a nominal mixes. So what is mean by nominal mixes? So the wide use of concrete as a construction material has led to the use of mixes based on the fixed proportion. As we know, IS 456-2000 has given basically seven mixes. These are nothing but your nominal mixes that are treated as a nominal mixes. These are called as a nominal mixes. Means the grade designation which is already having the proportion that you can say the your nominal concrete mixes. Okay, the offer simplicity and under normal circumstances has a margin for a strength as a specified one. Okay, if you are using M10, so 10 is having the compressive strength of your concrete. It should not be have a margin greater than 8, not less than 8 or not greater than 12. Okay, so these are the specified margin. Now the nominal mixes of concrete may be used for a concrete grade. So always remember the concrete grade for nominal mixes. Okay, M5, M75, N7.5, M10, M15 and M20. So these are treated as a nominal concrete mixes. And also these are the groups belong to which type of concrete? M10 say M20 is belongs to ordinary concrete. Okay, so ordinary concrete is nothing but your nominal mixes. What are these? These are the nominal concrete mixes. Okay, now the next is nothing but the proportion of your ingredient. These are the proportion. Grade is M5, then your CFA and CA. What is C? Cement, fine aggregate and coarse aggregate. Okay, so M5, the mix proportion is 1:5:10. M7.5 is nothing but 1:4:8. M10 is having the proportion 1:3:6. M15, 1:2:4. And M20 is nothing but 1:1.5:3. So take the ingredient of nominal mixes and their proportion screenshot so that you can remember the proportion as if it will come in a multiple choice question, okay, for your online exam. So also I have want to know you that ki M5 to M20 is generally used in a construction of PCC. What is PCC? It is nothing but plain cement concrete. And where is to provide PCC? PCC is provided below the bed of your concrete footing. It is act as a bed for your concrete footing. The purpose of your PCC for construction purpose is only is that it should be level. Your footing should be level while you are constructing your footing. To give the level surface at the ground, you should provide M5 to up to M10 grade of proportion. Above M10, you can say M15, M20 and M25 are going to use for design of your construction. That is nothing but building design or rest of the design. But only M7.5 and M10 is not used for construction of your column or construction of your beam or construction of your slab. M15 se above hi you will need to use for your construction of slab, beam and column. And for construction of your PCC which is below the footing which is generally provided to give the level surface of your concrete to your footing, you will need to provide M5 to grade of concrete to the M10 grade of concrete. So these are the ingredients for your nominal mixes, and you should take a screenshot of this slide. Okay, so this is very important, and also remember which type of concrete grade and where to use which type of concrete grades. Okay, in RCC you will need to use above M15. Always remember, in RCC type of construction you will need to use M50 above M50 grade of concrete. Okay, now we will see in your syllabus the next topic is factor influencing the choice of mixed design. What are the different choice of mixed design? According to IS 456-2000 and IS 1343-1980, the important influencing design of concrete mix are. So always remember, the factor which are influencing your concrete mix design is given in IS 456 and 2000 as well as 1343 and 1980. But to design a concrete mix design as per IS, you will need to use which IS code? You will need to use IS 1026-9-2009. That is a code which gives you the design steps for your concrete mix. But factor which are influencing that design mix is given in IS 456-2000 and IS 1343-1980. Okay, so always remember the code for concrete mix design and factor influence. Okay, this is a multiple choice question. Now the what are the different factor? The grade of concrete, type of cement, maximum nominal size of aggregate, grading of combined aggregate, maximum water cement ratio, workability of concrete, durability and quality control. These are the generally major factors which are going to influence your design mix. Okay, so we'll see one by one. The first one is nothing but grade of concrete. The grade of concrete gives the characteristic compressive strength. We know that. Suppose M10. 10 is give the characteristic compressive strength. It is one of the important factor which influence your design. How it influence? See, the grade M20 denotes the characteristic compressive strength, which is nothing but FCK Newton per mm square. Depending upon the degree of control available at a site, the concrete mix is to be designed for the target mean compressive strength, which is nothing but FCK dash. Okay, for applying the suitable standard deviation. So that's why I have taken first numerical, then I have take the factor which are influencing your design, because you know, now you know what is the target strain and what is the standard deviation. Hai na? I hope you know. Nahi pata to jaane do. Hai na? So target strength is nothing but FCK dash is equal to FCK plus K into S. K is nothing but 1.65 and S is nothing but your standard deviation. Okay, grade of concrete should be more below the above the M20 for your concrete mix design. Now you can see these are the group which is nothing but lead mixes, ordinary mixes and design mixes to influence your choice of design mix. So always remember, for mixed design you will need to use a concrete grade above M25, but in your syllabus it is given in your syllabus that design a concrete mix for M25 grade of concrete as per IS 1026-9-2009. It is in your syllabus. So you are only belongs to up to M25 grade of concrete. Rest of the proportion you should remember. M5 having the 1:5:10. We have already seen. M7.5 is 1:4:8. M10 is having 1:3:6. M15 1:2:4, M20 1:1.5:3, and M25 is having the mixed proportion as 1:1:2. Though to correct this proportion, you will need to design a concrete mix. Okay, so always remember the group as we have seen. M5 say M10 tak ordinary rehta hai, but M5 and M7.5 is also having the different group, that is nothing but a lean mixes. Okay, so these are the different concrete grades. And also, I want to tell you that apart from this designation, means up to M5 and M60, above M60 also, there are most of the M, means there are M80, M75, M85, M100, M150 also they are using in the construction of your design of different, you can say the historical purpose. You, if you are saving the, not historical, suppose you are saying the Burj Khalifa, in Burj Khalifa, they have used also M90 concrete also. M90 grade of concrete as well as M80 grade of concrete for construction of your this iconic structure. Okay, so apart from this designation, there are several designations are also available. You can also go for their concrete mix design if you want to. Okay, now the second factor which are going to influence your mix design is a cement. The rate of development of strength of concrete is depend upon the cement. The higher the strength of cement contained, the lesser will be the cement. Higher will be the strength, the lesser will be the cement content. Okay. If you are using 43 grade of cement or 53 grade of cement, which gives the cement consumption up to 15% to 25%. Also, remember the cement consumption for OPC 40 and OPC 53. Okay. As compared to 33 grade of concrete, are giving the more cement consumption, 50% and 25%, 43 and 53 than 33. Okay, so these are the different your cement consumption. Means what? You will need to use which grade of concrete? 43 and 53 because it gives the more cement consumption. Next factor which are going to influence is maximum size of aggregate. We know that maximum nominal size of aggregate is nothing but 10, 20 and 30, which is in mm. The maximum coarse aggregate is determined by the sieve analysis. We have already done this practical. It is designated by the sieve size higher than the larger size of on which 15% or more aggregate is retained. That also we have seen, we have done with the sieve analysis. This practical, I hope you are remembering the fineness modulus of your aggregate. By doing the fineness modulus of your aggregate, you can able to identify the how much percentage of more retained on your each type of sieve. So that will be give you the nominal size of your aggregate, maximum nominal size of your aggregate. So generally, for coarse aggregate should not be more than 1/4 of minimum thickness of the member. 1/4 of minimum thickness of the member. So the maximum nominal size is also the for heavy reinforced concrete. In case of ribs or of a main beam, in ribs of a main beam, the nominal maximum size of aggregate should usually restricted the sum of less than the clearance distance between the main bar or 5 mm less than the minimum cover to the reinforcement, wherever it is a smaller. Means what? If you know that while providing the reinforcement, we should keep some clearance between the bottom of your concrete to the bottom of your reinforcement. That is nothing but that will give you the clear distance. If you are having the maximum size of aggregate, then that the clear distance, then the aggregate is not possible to pour into that clearance distance. So that you will need to provide the maximum nominal size aggregate. So that the don't talk. Let me talk only. Okay, mute your all button if you want to talk. So clear distance should be considered while consider your maximum size of aggregate, as well as workability of concrete increase with the increase in maximum size of aggregate. But smaller size of aggregate provide the larger surface area for bonding with the mortar matrix with than the which gives the higher strength. We know that if you are using maximum size of aggregate will give the more area for your absorption of your water content and all that, which directly increase your strength of concrete. Okay, the next factor is nothing but grading of combined aggregate. What is the grading of combined aggregate? If you see, it is essential that fine and coarse aggregate will be well graded. In case of the aggregate available for natural source do not conform to the specified grading, the proportion of two or more aggregate become the essential. See, if you are using fine aggregate and coarse aggregate for your coarse for your dense concrete, for preparing of your dense concrete, and which is available from the natural sources, it should not conform to the specified grading. You should confirm before taking into the construction, you should confirm the size of aggregate which is specified as per your IS. Okay, so this is the combined grading. If you are using the different well graded, means you are using coarse aggregate as well as fine aggregate, so you should define your specified grading, then only you can use your aggregate. Now these are the different CU number. The following x-axis showing the CU number and y-axis the percentage of passing. So this graph is also you will need to draw in your fineness modulus experiment, as the red line is give you the red line is not give you the total red line is not giving you the total percentage passing. It will give you the percentage passing at a particular point of view. Means what? Suppose you are seeing the in between 50 and 60, they are giving you the particular red dot up to a CU number having the above the eight CU numbers, which is nothing but your maximum size of aggregate. These are the different grading zone. See, this grading zone is applicable for this slide only. You, in our practical point of view, you will need to draw your different CU number for your percentage passing for each type of aggregate. Okay, so this chart is not applicable for your point of view. Okay, these are the drawn for their point of view. Grading of combined aggregate. And next part is nothing but the maximum water cement ratio. First of all, I want to tell you that the water cement ratio is firstly given by the Abrahams. Who is Abraham? Abraham is the scientist who has discovered the water cement ratio, who discovered the water percentage should be added in your concrete by the percentage of weight of cement. Firstly given by Abrahams. Okay. Who states that for any given condition of test, the strength of a workability of concrete depend upon the only water cement ratio. Lower the water cement ratio, the greater is the compressive strength. Lower the water cement ratio, the greater is the compressive strength. So Abraham is the one who gives the maximum, who gives the water cement ratio first into the picture for the concrete mix design. Abraham is the scientist. Okay, so try to remember the name of the scientist who gave the first water cement ratio consideration. Now the next factor is the workability. We have seen the workability. Workability should not be harmful without a segregation and without a bleeding. It should be provided. Then only you can say that it is a proper workability. If you are giving the excess vibration, then definitely there will be the segregation and bleeding from the concrete. So while transporting, mixing and placing of your concrete, you should take a proper precaution in case of segregation and bleeding point of view. It should not happen in your workable concrete. So do not give excess vibration. Okay. Now the next part is nothing but durability. Durable concrete should have the lower water cement ratio. And you know that how to achieve the lower water cement by using the different admixture, you can achieve the durability of your concrete. Now the next topic in your syllabus is method of concrete mix design. As we have seen yesterday in our last lecture, you can say the IS method. IS method is having a code IS10269-2009, which is nothing but your IS code method. And the rest of the method is you will need to remember ACI method, road number 4 method, which is the UK method. You can also say IRC44 method, arbitrary method, maximum density method, fineness modulus method, surface area mix design. This is a mix design for high strength concrete, mix design for pumpable concrete, and DOE mix design method, which is nothing but a British method. So take a screenshot of this slide. These are the different method you will need to see in your syllabus for your, but as per as a design point of view, you will need to only design your concrete mix for M25 by using IS code method, and you can say the DOE method, which is nothing but British method. So these are the two point, these are the two methods you will need to use in your concrete mix design. But the rest of the name you should remember: IS code method, ACI method, road number 4 method, and rest of the method. So take a screenshot of this slide so that you can remember the different method of concrete mix design. Okay, so IS code method, you know, for different IS code method, we have designed FCK dash. What are the different IS code method apart from IS 10269? The Bureau of Indian Standard recommended a set of procedure for design of mix. The procedure is based upon the research work. This is depend upon the research work carried out at a national laboratories. Data for the mix design, what data is required? Characteristic compressive strength. What is meant by characteristic compressive strength? Suppose you are designing M25 grade of concrete. So M25 indicate that characteristic compressive strength. That 25 is calculated in a national laboratory. Means what? You will need to first know the data before designing of your concrete mix design. Okay, so this is the IS code method, and degree of desired workability, desired limitations of water cement ratio with a minimum cement to ensure the adequate durability, type and maximum size of aggregates, and standard deviation. So we know that how to design your concrete mix design based on IS method. IS is having IS code which is going to use in concrete mix design is 10269. Try to remember the number 10269-2009 we are going to use. Okay, actually we have already used in our last lecture. These are the different steps. You can see we have already gone through that. Okay, so are you getting this all the thing? In this lecture, I was trying to cover the the factor which are influence your design mix. So, are you getting this? Hello, students.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, have you listened throughout lecture? I hope.